Hi there, my name is Elise Johnson and I'm with DB Services. Today I'll be taking you on a tour of FM Quickstart 19. FM Quickstart is DB Services' free CRM app for FileMaker, which is totally free and unlocked. We've recently added some great new features to this product, as well as our new FM Quickstart implementation plans that I'll be discussing at the end. Let's dive in here. So if you've used previous versions of FM Quickstart, the first thing you'll notice in FM Quickstart 19 is major changes to our user interface, including the sidebar navigation, which you can see over here. This is not only on our dashboard screen, but on our other modules as well, as you can see here on the left. So this will make it quick and easy to scroll through your records on FM Quickstart in a better way than before. So another new feature that we have at this time is our task list. Now our tasks here, you can create different tasks for users on FM Quickstart in your organization and assign those particular companies or contacts to a particular task. So as you can see here, I've created a sales task for the contact John Doe. I've added some details in here, a start and end time, and I will save that here. You can also check these off as you complete them to remove them from the list and click the Show Completed button to show all of them. And these actually tie over to our calendar module, which is brand new. So the long-awaited FM Quickstart calendar is finally here. And you can manage all of your tasks from the calendar screen as well. So as you can see, you can edit your tasks from this screen and also view your calendar on a monthly, weekly, or daily, or list view, so you can take a look at all of those. So you can also see our dashboard for sales and production are still on FM Quickstart on the front dashboard. So for the sales dashboard, you're looking at open quotes that you have here, as well as prospects where you can add follow-up dates for particular prospects and assign particular users to each prospect as well. And then for the production dashboard, you can see the unpaid orders and pending shipments over here. So let's review the other modules now that are already around in previous versions. So the first would be the companies module. You can add details about each company that you have in here, such as multiple locations, as well as your points of contact for the company. Any tasks you've created will also fall under here. And you can also see POs, quotes, orders, shipments, and you can also store documents in FM Quickstart, which is a great feature as well. You can also add some notes in here. For locations, you can view the tasks, quotes, orders, shipments, and documents for a particular location, and also order those contacts for that particular location here as well. For contacts, it's a great way to look at your customers and prospects in an intuitive way, and you can even add pictures for your customers or prospects here to help with that facial recognition in the sales portion of things. So contacts can be assigned to users as well, as you can see, so that'll help your sales team stay active and on top of their prospects and customers. And you can also see quotes, orders, shipments, tasks that have been assigned, including the ones that I put in here earlier, documents, notes, and even charts, which is a handy feature here. You can look at sales by month or sales by year for a particular contact. So the quotes, orders, and shipment modules all up here tie into one another, as you would guess. So for quotes, you can actually see on the top right here the sales pipeline of going from quote to order to shipment. And you can actually click through and it'll take you to the coordinating order and shipment for a particular quote. So as you can see on quotes, you have the line items, any extra documents you might need, and notes. Can also calculate shipping and tax over here as well. You can assign it to a customer, customer type, and add all these details in here as well. For orders, same thing over here with the line items. Once you ship the item, you'll have a shipment created and it will show up here as well for the order. You can add in payment information for a particular order as well. If you've taken a payment such as through QuickBooks or Stripe or something similar, so you can keep track of that. And then once your order has shipped, you'll have a shipment record created. If any returns need to be done, you can create that here and add any documents or notes that you might need. So there are two reports that we have pre-built out in FM Quickstart 19. The first would be the sales report, which you can choose a date range, salesperson that you'd like to view, and even a contact that you'd like to review, and run that report, and it'll spit this out for you. And accounts receivable is pretty straightforward as well. You can also choose a salesperson or contact for accounts receivable. So there are a few critical features that are put under the setup tab, so we'll run through those really quickly for you. So the products module is where you will add products or delete products as needed and update them so that they will show up correctly on your quotes and orders. You can see here we've even got a picture in for this particular item, a category, all the pricing that you need to know, the amount of quantities that you have, and then you can see where this shows up other places in FM Quickstart, so quotes, order, shipments, purchase orders, receiving, vendors that you might purchase from, production, and even returns. You can also see charts here for sales by month and sales by year, just like your contacts. So this is a pretty crucial one. You'll also want to look at purchase orders for anything that you'll be purchasing from other companies. You will get your line items here, and it will create a receiving for you when that is ready. You can add your payments in here. And also go to the receiving module to create the receiving here. You can also see in the top right the purchase order and then going to the receiving here. In returns is where you would handle any customer returns that you might have. And this will show up under the particular quote or order that you have. Under users is where you'll set up other users for FM Quickstart. You can add the accounts here and set up their permissions, their default dashboard, set up their information, and either activate or deactivate here in the top right for all of your users. And finally, you can take a look at the preferences to make FM Quickstart more aligned with your personal company brand. You can update the logos here, your company information and address over here, and get that all aligned with your company to make FM Quickstart your very own. So I hope you enjoyed this comprehensive look at FM Quickstart 19. We're proud to be presenting this product to the public totally free and unlocked for you. However, if you are looking for assistance in getting started, you may be interested in our FM Quickstart implementation plans. We offer three levels of these plans to help you get your data into FMQ and make it your own, as well as additional licensing and development consulting. Please check out our page on fmquickstart.com for the implementation plan details. And if you have any questions, feedback, or any other FileMaker needs, DB Services is ready to help you. Please give us a call at 888-488-0191 or fill out a contact form on our website at dbservices.com. Thank you so much for checking out FileMaker Quickstart 19, FM Quickstart 19, and we hope you enjoy and happy filemaking.